Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to pay bills in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. If you previously entered bills into QuickBooks, then the next step is to pay them before they become due. Paying bills in QuickBooks will automatically mark the bill as paid, and it will no longer be outstanding. This will also update the accounts payable balance to reflect the bill payment. Accounts payable is the amount that you owe to vendors. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, after you've logged into your QuickBooks Online account, from the homepage, go ahead and click the plus sign and select Pay Bills right below the Vendors column. The Pay Bills window will display. We will walk through each field as we pay a couple of bills for Paul's Plumbing. Payment Account. Select from the dropdown the bank account that you will make these payments from. The payment date will typically be your check date. The starting check number that you want to enter here, if you are going to print the check immediately, then go ahead and enter the starting check number that you will load into the printer. If this is your first time printing checks, click here for step-by-step instructions on where to buy and how to print checks in QuickBooks Online. If you are going to print checks later, go ahead and click the Print Later box. Also notice to the right that QuickBooks will provide you with notifications of the number of outstanding bills that you have to pay. So we've got two open bills here that happen to be for the same vendor. Bill selection. This first column allows you to put a check mark next to the bills that you would like to pay. This next column is payee. This is a payee for the check. Typically, this will be your vendor's name, but if for some reason the payee differs from your vendor's business name, then you can update the vendor profile with this information. In the Setting Up Vendors lesson, we walk through step-by-step how to set up your vendors in QuickBooks. Click here to watch this video tutorial. The reference number is the vendor's invoice number that you entered. This is the due date of the bill in this next column. Notice that QuickBooks will also indicate with an exclamation point if the bill is past due. The next column is the open balance that is due. And then the column after that, credit applied. If you have entered any credits that you received from your supplier, they will show up here to reduce the amount that you owe. You've got a couple of ways to indicate how much you want to pay for each bill. So the first way is you can actually put a check mark in that first column, and QuickBooks will automatically populate the payment field with the total amount due for that invoice. The other way that you can do it is if you want to make a partial payment for an invoice and not pay it in its entirety, you can simply type the amount that you'd like to pay in the payment field. And once you do that and press the tab key, QuickBooks will automatically put a check mark next to that invoice as well. So we're going to pay half of the open balance due for the second invoice here. And now we've got our total amount that we're going to pay. Two faucets are us. And we will pay both of these invoices using one check. So once you have completed this field, we can go ahead and save and close. And we want to go to the check register to locate the payment that we just created. So from the left-hand menu bar, you want to click on Transactions and then Banking. On the right, you want to click the link that says Go to Check Register. To confirm that payment was correctly applied, we want to go ahead and review the bills that we just paid. So this first one, we'll take a look at it. This was the bill that had a total amount due of $500. We made a partial payment that's indicated here. And so now we have a balance due of $250 on this particular bill. And then the second bill that we paid in full. Bill number 98765, so we'll click on that, and that one shows paid in full. So we know our payments were applied correctly. To gain a better understanding of how entering bills will impact your financial statements and what's happening behind the scenes in QuickBooks, click this link to access the step-by-step instructions for this lesson. That wraps up the lesson on how to pay bills in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.